Do you have a messy kid at home? A maker, a creator, a kid with big dreams who's messy? This video might help you out. Hi, I'm Julie. I recently turned my super creative kid's room into a table. It looks like this. This video includes a lot of info about that bedroom and how we did it, plus a more in-depth look at the no-fold laundry system that I use at home. If you want an explanation on the planning side and even more details on the other features, go to video one. This video is part two because I had way more to show you. I think I said it, but I'm Julie. I help families get it together with systems. Sometimes I work with executive level women to set up operating systems at home so they can run the world at work and have home be easier and take less energy. Sometimes I work with whole families to get everyone helping out. Whoever I'm working with, we start by reorganizing the rooms in their home so that each room has a purpose and meets the needs of the family. We cannot put systems in place without that. So I had struggled for many years myself with a super creative, prolific maker kid whose room did not meet her needs. Just putting organizational systems into this didn't work. I needed to rethink the whole room. So it turned into a table. This is what it looks like.
She was like, oh my God, I could never wear that. And I was like, let me show you how to.
Abracadabra, these bitches know I got answers the way I pose for. So this entire video is a roll up of my TikTok journey to turn her room into a table.
A Birkin. Another Birkin. But what makes these two Birkins different? And what small feature about them divides the Hermes collector community? Let's talk about it.
Here's why I did it. Just turned my daughter's little kid room into her big kid room. Of course, it wasn't just about style for me. There were some problems that I wanted to solve. I'll show you. Easily accessible drawers. A shelf for displaying her Lego creations so nobody touches them. Organizational tools for her that are permanent. Changing up some of the artwork to display what she's been working on lately and what she's interested in now. And a huge amount of space for making things. And a cozy little bed area under here. I basically put all the organizing items underneath a big counter space. So she still has all the organizing in her dresser, but she has counter space on top. One of the big things we were looking for was increased surface area for her creations. Here's what that looks like, and also a little video of her creating in the room. Okay, but what if you had a whole lot of flat surface area? Yeah, baby, you so vicious, you so clean, so delicious.
Take it out no more. Bitch. I am healthy, I am wealthy, I am rich, I am that bitch. I am gonna go get that bag and I am not gonna take your.
I got a lot of comments, as you can imagine, on these videos on TikTok, and one of the most frequent comments I got was, my inner child loves that room. So here's what I said. This is the room on a normal day. If your inner child wants more surface area for all of your projects, including sometimes really big builds that take up this whole space, something like this might really help. If you look at it, a lot of it just looks trashy, right? But because it's all on the table, it's fine. She is free to experiment with all different kinds of organization. This does not match the way I would organize my space, but she is her own person. These are the things she wants to keep from people touching because they're special. All the rest of this is one big creative project that she is always tweaking and changing. And underneath here, we have space for big containers. I fill up this container right here with materials every week. Gold necklace, a bag I didn't want, tape, always tape, these little jewelry bags. Anything I find that I'm getting rid of, paper towel holders, magazines, I put in her materials bin so that she can use it to make her creative projects. My whole career, I've been a teacher and school principal. And at one of my schools, I brought a Montessori approach to the instruction there. Some of the planning that went into this table bedroom was about meeting my daughter's intellectual needs for doing work. And it was inspired by the Montessori approach. Here's more about that. In the Montessori tradition, there is a phrase, follow the child. If you work in a Montessori school, you get really good at watching kids work and figuring out what they need next or how to prepare the learning environment to better suit their work. Most regular people just know Montessori is a style or the way a room could look. Reality is, her toddler room looked more Montessori than this room, for sure. Few items on shelves and like item baskets. Very tidy. By comparison, this looks like an explosion, but this is also following the child. I basically figured out a way for her to have a full-time explosion of creativity all the time without it bothering me too much. And so far, we're both happy, which is what it's all about. My goal with this content is not to inspire you to create a table bedroom, but I really want to help people think about how to customize their spaces for themselves and their families. This is so kind of you to say. The fact is, I'm really lucky. I love thinking about customizing systems, and I get to do that a lot in my home with my daughter. That's the work of teaching. That's the work of parenting. It's a job I wasn't sure I was going to get to do. I see it as just one more way I get to put love in the world. It's fun for me. And yes, sometimes it's born out of frustration because she lives her life without a care in the world, and she certainly doesn't care about my preferences, but I get to figure out how to create things that are really customized to her, and that's just like a huge pleasure for me. So many people ask for a full tour. This is the full tour.
Of course I do. I will show you everything about this room. Here it is in its entirety, so you can get a sense of it. All started a couple of months ago when I saw the Bright Room series of Target organizers on Casey Davis's TikTok. Hi, Casey. And I just thought, this is what I need for my kid's dresser. This old vintage dresser where you can barely open the drawers, like, I'm over it. So there it is. That is the Bright Room organizer. And it turns out it's a little short, so we built this like kick plate at the bottom so it would be 31 inches high. This one's actually 31 inches high, and so is this one. Here, I'm just using a lot of open space and I use some different shelves for materials. You can see how we placed the plywood here and then did it for sort of maximum support in all the right places here. And then built in these little legs to make sure this huge piece of plywood didn't bow. And then underneath, you can see how it was secure. I'm gonna get in here and show you. I'm in her bed. I wanted her to have a nightstand. So I put another 31 inch Target cubby here facing her bed. This is actually from Target too, from a long time ago, 31 inches high. And that's how I got the idea of just making several bases that are 31 inches high and then putting plywood on top. This piece of plywood is exactly the size of a twin bed. It's 44 by maybe 90 to accommodate that. And then there's just a small twin mattress under there. One huge advantage is all that wasted space at the bottom of the kid's bed, stuffed animal storage. There are some other things in here that I really love. She wanted something to keep her creations protected. So this is a set of really thin shelves from Amazon. And then I did a lot of securing these trays so that we had some designated spaces for things. Special stuff, DVD. This is just a paper towel roll for her tape collection, and then this is another one of those organizers that's secure. These are the pieces of art she was willing to keep from her little kid room. Art by my daughter. And of course, these built-ins we made when she was born. So this is just sort of like basic carpentry, dowels, and a box. That is her room. I'll put a bunch of these items on the kids' room on my Amazon storefront.
One of the things we really needed was some improvement on the clothes situation at our house. We took inspiration from Casey Davis's no-fold laundry system. Here's the explanation.
Yes. Okay, this system is the Bright Room system from Target. Here is the set. I just built it into this desk, and it consists of these pull-out drawers. I have underwear and ballet clothes on the top, and then a bottom, there's one for shirts, one for shorts, and one for her uniforms. This is just pajamas and then laundry. I love being able to just hand her a pile of pajamas and she throws them in that bin. Works out really easy for us. Okay, you're right, this isn't obvious. Okay, that was her dresser before. It was one of those vintage drawers that was hard to open and close. Because the drawers were kind of narrow, it meant that we had to fold things to fit everything in there. And it mostly meant she just threw stuff on the floor. So when I found these Bright Room drawers at Target, they're perfect. They're meant for laundry, I think, anyway, And they're perfect for just sorting by type. There's three small drawers on the top and three big ones on the bottom. And the ones on the top are perfect for like underwear, bras, socks. And the ones on the bottom are perfect for shirts, shorts, uniforms. She can just pull open the shirts container and pick out from a pile of shirts. And for the same amount of clothes, it takes up less space than her other dresser does. So less work to clean up, less work to put clothes away, and takes up less space. Win-win.
And of course, with me, it's not just storage, it's a full system to best store clothes. Here's what I mean by a system.
Wherever my kid is putting on her pajamas, that's where the clothes end up on the floor. Living room, bathroom, wherever. So I made a little system. I'll show you. This is designed to stand right here, take your clothes off, put them in the hamper, and then put your pajamas on.
So far, it's working. A lot of people thought that this would disappear after a week. Here is the week one update.
Okay, it's been a week. I have a room update for you. Hi, I'm Julie. I made my kid's room into a table. Just to remind you, there were some working theories here that giving her more surface area and bigger spaces to create would help some of our problems. And there's some things I did to make it easier for her to clean up her room, which is to make trash can really big and make her hamper really easy to manage. So let's look at it. Okay, surface area. Working out. My favorite part is that she can have the bins of Legos and a workspace on the same table because this table is 44 inches wide. Here are some of my organizational tools still going strong. Here's the other one over here, still in place. Pencils in the cup. Under here, we have a big box for trash and a big box for materials for creating things. This system is hamper below, PJs on top. So far, things are working in here.
And in this final video, I talk about what I learned as a mom about my child and also about the way she uses space.
One thing I learned when I customized my kids' room and made it into a table is that if you give them space, they will show you all kinds of new things about what their brain is busy doing. This is what the table looks like. This is not a clean room. This is just the way it always looks. There are spaces here that I did not realize how she would use. Her Legos kept getting messed up after she made them. So we gave her shelves so she could display them. But look what's gone on the shelves. Not that many Legos. Awards and trophies and pictures of friends and her favorite joke and books that we wrote together. Not only does this room give her space to create, it's a real developmental milestone to go from favorite toys to picking out special moments to remember and save.
This was such a fun project at our house. To find out more, check out the first video. I also went on Casey Davis's podcast, Struggle Care, to talk about this whole process. If you're still interested in it, I put the link in the notes so you can go and listen. If you're interested in systems and routines at home to save mental energy, to bring your family less stress, to have more time to enjoy life with your family, please subscribe so that you can get notified when the next video drops. Thanks for watching.